this workshop is going to be about how to do things that originated in modern art, and how you can, if you learn them, you can add them to whatever you do, and in watercolor.
That's our five Rosefelt on video.
On video. Oh, that was great.
Doesn't
have a name.
It didn't put the name of the
artist
on there.
Here's something that's all geometry. We don't know whether it represents anything or not. If it did, it's pretty much gone by now. Uh-huh. But, you know, look how powerful this is. This is very decorative in its own right. And just, it looks kind of like a person. Mm-hmm. You know, it's got legs, a head, a body. I don't know what. Then it's just bone. It's bone. It's just a sponge. You can get them at Publix or any grocery store, you know, wherever the cleaning goods are. And I love them because I put them in here so that I can, when I lay my brushes down on them, and the brushes are wet, and there's a place to soak some of this up. I've done some abstracts that were, I still got, I don't know where it is now, somewhere over, it's hanging up on some wall for sale, but it's a big abstract in acrylic on paper, and, you know, I didn't know what to call it, because it wasn't, to me, it wasn't about anything, so it's got some pink passages in, and so Karen Jurassic, who's the co-owner of the Comma Gallery, came in. She and I critique each other's work, and she came in and looked at it. She talked to me about it. Everything was real positive. And then she said, "But you know what?" And I said, "What?" She said, "Pink doesn't sell." So I named the painting "Pink Doesn't Sell."